So, the purpose of yoga practice is to promote or to leave this material atmosphere and enter into the spiritual atmosphere, all the yogis. But the jnana yogi, they remain in the impersonal feature of the Absolute Truth. The dhyana yoga is practicing the localized aspect, but the bhakti yogi is promoted directly in the planet which is called Goloka Vrindavan, and there he associates with the Supreme Personality of Godhead and enjoys life blissfully eternal. So there are different planetary systems within this material world. Just like we are situated, it is called Bhurloka. Above this there is Bhuvarloka. Above that there is Saraloka, there is Janaloka, there is Mahaloka, Sattaloka. In this way there are seven steps of planetary system up and similarly seven planetary system down. So, by Jnana Yoga, by Dhyana Yoga, means mystic yoga system, we can be promoted to the higher planetary system. But if you practice the Bhakti Yoga, then you go to the transcendental world directly and associate with the Supreme Personality of God. The Dhyana Yogi and Jnana Yogi can also go to the Brahma Loka or Brahma Jyoti, but there is chance of falling down again to this material world. But generally, Jnana Yogi remains a speculator within this material world, and Dhyana Yogi, they, as soon as they get some material miracle power, they become implicated with this power, no more going to the spiritual world. But Bhakta Yogi, being perfectly the yogi, the topmost yogi, he can enter the kingdom of God or the planet where God is there. God is everywhere, but he has got a special planet which is called Goloka Vrindavan. You can enter there and mix with the Supreme Lord, just like we are here, mixing one another. I can see, you can see me. Similarly, you can go directly see God and live with Him, dance with Him, play with Him, eat with Him. That is the perfection of life. This perfection of yoga can be achieved by practicing bhakti yoga as it is recommended here. Mayasaktamanaprathajyogamjanjanamadasra. Under the guidance of the Supreme Personality of Godhead or His representative, bona fide. If you practice this yoga, then you can understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead, incomplete, without any doubt. And if you practice this yoga in this life and try to understand Krishna, what He is, then after giving up this body, you have to give up this body, today or tomorrow, then you go directly to Krishna. It is, therefore, explained in the fourth chapter, Janma karma me dibbam jo janati tattata takta dehang punar janma naiti maameti kaunsya. My dear Arjuna, anyone, if he simply tries to understand why I come in this material world, what is my mission, what do I do, if he simply will understand, then he immediately becomes fit for being transferred to the spiritual world. So our Krishna consciousness movement is to educate people how to understand Krishna and then make his life perfect. Thank you very much. Any question?
So he's saying that many people are wondering why we are making so much propaganda for our Krishna conscious movement, because usually India doesn't make propaganda for our philosophy.
He does not know what is India. In India, he'll see village to village, they are chanting Hare Krishna. In every village, in every town, there is a place which is called Hari Sabha, or every neighborhood. Now, after the British rule, they have forgotten this culture. But the originally, every village, every town, there is a club or society where this Hare Krishna chanting is going on. And besides that, 500 years ago, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there, all over India, he traveled and preached the Sankirtan movement. Not only that, he has ordered to his followers, to his devotees, not only devotees, he has ordered to every Indian to preach the Sankirtan movement all over the world. So he has said in these words that Bharat Bhumite Manusha Janma Hoilo Ja Janma Sarthakari Karo Paropoka, means anyone who has taken birth in India as human being, he must make his life perfect and preach this cult all over the world. And he has also said, Prithivite ache jato nagoradi gram sarvato prachar hoibe morna, mean that as many villages and towns are there on the surface of the globe, everywhere this Hare Krishna mantra will be preached. So this Hare Krishna movement or Krishna consciousness has just begun. You will see in future, in every village, every town, they will chant and dance. So it is the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prediction that is being fulfilled. Nobody can check it. Already we have got about 100 branches all over the world and all kinds of people taking part in this movement.
Without rejecting their own religion, take to Krishna consciousness.
Well, it is not rejecting, it is reforming. The Catholic religion also teaches love of God or love of Christ. So, if I say the truth, it will not be very palatable. But this movement is reformation. But another thing is, Catholic, Hindu, Muslim, or whatever you may be, everyone accepts there is God. So we are teaching not to formally accept there is God, but know what is God and love Him. So those who are interested for higher knowledge of God, they will take it. The point is simply officially to accept God, there is God. No, you know what is God, what is His feature, what He is doing, what is acting, what is His name, what is His address. Everything you know and try to love Him. That you are teaching. So those who are actually serious to know about God, they will come to this movement. Those who simply know God, officially there is God, that's all. That is a different thing. That is also good. But if you want to know more, then you have to take this Krishna consciousness. We are therefore presenting these books, 80 books, 400 pages each, just to explain what is God. So it is a great science. Any intelligent man will appreciate. And we are getting good response, especially in America. Big, big university, college, professors, they are now purchasing. We have proposed to publish Srimad Bhagavatam in 60 volumes. But we have published only 14. But still, the big, big professors, they are giving us order, forward order for all the 60 volumes. As soon as scholarly people, they read this book, they will welcome this movement all over the world. Is that all right or anymore? Any more questions?
She would like to know if our religion can bring something more than the other religions.
There is one religion. One who knows God, he is religion. One who does not know God, that religion has no meaning. Religion means to understand the order of God. That is it. But if you do not know what is God and how you can hear His order. So religion without understanding of God philosophically and logically is sentiment. And philosophy without understanding of God is mental speculation. So when philosophy and religious sentiments combine, that is called religion. Otherwise it is not religion.